Let me start with the most important matter facing our country at this dire moment, which is the matter of the Senate dress code, which has recently been changed.
Of course, yes, yeah, no, of course. I've heard that some people are upset about that, and the right have been like losing their mind. You know, they're just like, oh my God, you know, dogs and cats are living together, and you know, like I said, aren't there more important things we should be talking about rather than if I dress like a slob?
There certainly are more important things to be talking about, but some are talking about the dress code for senators. And I think it's worth talking about, especially because apparently Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer very quietly changed the Senate's already informal dress code late last week to basically allow senators like John Fetterman, for instance, to wear pretty much whatever they want on the Senate floor. Now, this has led to some, I would say, faux outrage and backlash from Republican members of the House, including Marjorie Taylor Greene, who had no problem showing, you know, Hunter Biden's penis in the context of a House hearing. So if she wants to talk about decorum and being respectable and presenting yourself in a respectable manner, she might not be the best spokesperson for that. But nonetheless, I am curious what you think about this, Cenk, because while I love Fetterman, while my opinion on how he presents himself through the way he dresses really has no bearing on how much I like him as a politician, I do kind of have a problem with the unprofessional nature in which he and Kirsten Sinema dress on the Senate floor. Just keeping it real.
That's
interesting. Sorry.
Okay, well, we're gonna poll. We're gonna ask you guys, because I'm actually a little undecided about this. There is one thing I am decided about in Fetterman's appearance though, and that 70s porn mustache has gotta go. Okay, the goatee, the goatee's totally fine. Nothing wrong with a goatee, nothing wrong with a beard, nothing wrong with clean shaven, but Raleigh Fingers over there has gotta stop doing 70s porn. Okay, so sorry. Okay, now having said that, let's get to the real issue, which is also goofy, but it's not perfectly goofy. Because the reason I'm torn on this is because on the one hand, I hate etiquette overall, because it's just—
No, disagree.
Hold on. It feels 90% of the time to me as silly old rules, and a lot of I do declare, and a lot of people holding their pinkies like this, okay? And I think that those guys substitute that for the etiquette and the politeness for kindness, which is a very different thing, which they don't have. And they use it as a facade, and I don't like that. And I like breaking down those norms, right? Now, having said that, these days the norms have broken to smithereens. And since things are spiraling out of control, I'm not sure I want them to spiral further. So are they gonna come in now with like tank tops and beach hats and flip flops and I'm starting to get a little uncomfortable, right? Even though it's my boy, I love Fetterman, right? Mm-hmm. And so I have never been concerned about Sinema's dress. First of all, these days I don't think I'm allowed to have an opinion on it, but I legitimately never had an opinion.
You can have an opinion on it. I will allow it. Okay. And if people get mad, they can get mad.
But no, I'm kidding around.
Come on, she's a United States Senator. Like, oh, are you punching down? Like.
No, I'm kidding around because some people take offense at it, but I don't care, okay? But I genuinely don't care about that. But with Fetterman, yeah, if everyone in the Senate and House dressed like that, it does feel a little unraveling, but I still haven't made up my mind. So make a more of a case for it.
I just want a little bit of professionalism, a little bit of order, because these are people who aren't just representing themselves, they're representing us and they're representing the country, right? If you can't be bothered to just dress professionally for the work you do, I mean, it's just, to me, it signals that you don't really feel that we're entitled to anything from you, right? Like, I just don't like it. I think it's, look, I have a strong bias against it, and it's partly because of certain things I've experienced, right? So I kick students out when they roll out of bed and show up to class wearing their pajamas. Get out. You don't respect me, you don't respect this classroom, get out.
Wow.
Go put some clothes on.
Professor.
Okay? I don't need to see your SpongeBob SquarePants pajama pants. I'm not interested. Okay? It's just, to me, it's a sign of disrespect for the entire classroom. And in this case, it's a sign of disrespect for the Senate floor and the country. And I'm saying this in regard to a Democratic senator who I really, really like, and a now independent senator who I really, really dislike. But nonetheless, this isn't about politics. It's just about being presentable, representing yourself in the best possible way, representing the country and your constituents in the best possible way, and just taking your job a little more seriously. Like, it's okay to take the hoodie off for a minute and wear a button down shirt.
Yeah.
And by the way, while the dress code has been loosened for the senators, that's not the case for the staff. The staff is still expected to wear business attire when they show up to work.
Well, that's another problem, right? So now you got two tiers. And it's weird that the senators can be sloppier than their staff. So, all right, look, first of all, obviously I care what you think here because I haven't made up my mind. tyt.com/polls/dress code. But you can just go, look, two things. Whenever we do polls, petitions, anything, you could always get the link in the description box if you're watching later on YouTube or Facebook, okay? And second of all, you could always just go to tyt.com/polls and you'll see it there. All right, so you tell us what you think. But I want to go to Kristen Sinema's outfits to give people context, and maybe that'll help me and you sort this out. You got that, Casper?
I do. Let's go to graphic one. Listen, this isn't a nightclub. Okay, you're reporting to work. It's the United States Senate. There are 100 of you, literally just 100 of you, some of the most powerful people in the country. Just show up like an adult, please. And but you want to wear whatever you want to wear in your free time. That's totally fine with me. I just don't understand like why this needs to happen in the context of work. You guys want to know what I like to wear in my free time? I like to wear little sundresses, okay? Little sundresses that would be way too unprofessional to wear on the show. Right?
A lot of guys are going to the poll right now going, no, wear it, wear it, wear it.
Like, look, I'm just keeping it real. Hate wearing bras. I wear like sundresses with no bra on. That's unprofessional. I'm not going to show up to it because I respect you guys and I want you to listen to what I'm saying instead of be distracted by what I'm wearing.
And same exact reason why I don't wear the tank tops and the midriffs. You know, I don't want to distract you guys with this hashtag too strong body. Okay, so seriously, I didn't see a problem with the cinema outfits except the one all the way on the right that seemed a little too informal. So the one with the orange pants and the, I'm just against any kind of clogs or flip flops in the Senate. That's my only. But others, I can't tell. They look professional to me, but I don't know anything. But Anna, what's interesting is that you also take great offense when people tell you what to wear, though.
Right.
Like, and we've talked about it on the show before.
It depends on the context, Cenk. So I'll give you an example. So several years ago, the Senate actually had already loosened some of their dress code, which I agreed with entirely because they were basically attacking women for wearing dresses, like power dresses, professional business attire dresses on the Senate floor, but sleeveless, right? There's no cleavage, there's no nothing, but it's just you can see the arms, right? Why is that a problem? I don't think that's a problem at all. And time to time, I'll get some salty woman who's watching the show message us about how me baring my arms is unprofessional. Yeah, damn right I'll get upset about that. Mm-hmm. Like, I know how to dress professionally. My arms are not some sexual, like, my arms are not like genitals, okay? Everything's gonna be fine. So I do have like, I'm not like a total prude about it, but at the same time, I think that there's like a clear distinction between dressing professionally, you could still bare your arms, it's gonna be all right, versus like whatever Kyrsten Sinema's into.
So you do believe in a right to bear arms?
I do believe in a right to bear arms in this specific context. And by the way, look, there are some concerns about Fetterman in particular, right? Because of the fact that he suffered a stroke. That might have an impact on his motor skills. Dealing with buttons might be difficult. Totally understand that. I think, you know, sweater vests are real hot these days.
Seven?
No. And look, that is a legitimate concern. So I take that into account and it is what it is. And if that's the case, then that's fine. Then an exception should be made for him for sure. But I think like loosening up to the point where you could wear literally whatever you want on the Senate floor, I'm just not into it. I think it's sloppy. I think it's unprofessional. I just don't like it.
Yeah, sweater vest poll on two. No, I'm kidding. Okay, but I will tell you, I'll leave the story on this. It's not every day that you'll get a story where I don't have a strong opinion.
Cenk, you do have a strong opinion. I have a problem with the way you dress.
Okay.
Look at that button-down shirt he's wearing from like, I don't know, 1996 maybe. It's faded, Cenk. It's so faded. Go to his one shot.
Are you kidding me? I only got this like 5-6 years ago.
Faded, Cenk.
Okay, my other shirt's like 10 to 20 years old.
You guys think that I only have the standard for the politicians. So you don't know how many times I've talked to Cenk about his appearance on the show.
I almost wore the gray version of this the other day on doing a podcast interview, and it's all frayed.
He's a CEO. He's the CEO of this company, and he's on air, but he can't be bothered to buy a new shirt.
Well, it's not just bothered too, right? There's other issues too. But anyways, so tyt.com/polls, you tell us, because I apparently am disqualified by my own dress for voting in this poll, which there's a twist I didn't see coming in this story.
Sorry, but at least justice is here.
Good wardrobe's not here, but at least justice is here. tyt.com/justice, we'll put that in the description box too.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.